across America.
Tickets go on sale for the American leg of Paul McCartney's first concert tour in 13 years. The last time out, McCartney was on the road with his former band, Wings. This time around, McCartney is touring with a new band that still includes his wife, Linda, on keyboards. The tour will feature songs from his new album, but also some oldies from his days as a Beatle. I sat down to talk with Paul McCartney in New York after a preview of the new band. After 13 years, did you decide to get out on the road again?
I was making this last album, Flowers in the Dirt, and really got on well with the musicians. We had a laugh. We seemed to enjoy each other's company. So what we did eventually was just thought, well, you know, the logical progression from that is to stay as a band. And what should we do? Go on tour, you know, sounds like the thing to do. And I think because I'm comfortable with them and I enjoy making music with them and it's not any kind of a pressure, you know, it beats just sitting around.
But seeing The Who and Ringo and even Grateful Dead go back on tour, wasn't that a
Rolling
bit of a
Stones.
Lure? For, yeah, a bit of a lure for you?
Yeah, it's it was very interesting a couple of years ago to see the Dead being so popular. Because I think a lot of people, you know, took the obvious point of view. She's always wrong in life. You know, the obvious one is, well, these guys are just too old. You know, the young guys are coming through and they're going to be better. But the Grateful Dead proved people wrong. You know, the kids, I mean, are you talking about not 40-year-old people going to their shows? You're talking about younger than 20, a lot of the audience, you know. So I think that gave a lot of people like myself, Stones and Who, encouragement.
You don't have any apprehensions that maybe you won't be able to spark a crowd like you did 20 years ago?
No, baby. I don't.
Include in the tour is going to start pre-Beatles up to present. How in the world did you select the few songs that you want to do?
I actually just sat down and thought, if I was going to this show, what would I like them to do? And I just chose a lot of songs, just wrote a list. I started off with about a list of about 35. Those were mainly Beatles and Wings. So to that we've added a new album, and then, because I hadn't done it when I made that list, and some rock and roll stuff. Do a couple of those because they're like irresistible, you know. We tend to throw them away. We just think, oh, we'll just throw in a rock and roll thing. But people like that stuff.
Oh, yeah.
You know, if you say, oh, man. And the good thing about, like, us older guys is that we were there. Us older guys, what are you talking about? Yeah, it's true. But, you know, we were there. We were in the 50s. So it's not like we're having to learn an old style of music. I mean, it's our style of music. We kind of grew up with it.
As hard as it is for anyone to imagine themselves getting old, it is equally hard to imagine you being 47 years old now. That sort of dates all of us, I guess.
Sure does, yeah. People tend to gauge themselves by people like me and Ringo and stuff. I remember I used to gauge myself by Brigitte Bardot. I read one day she's 50. I went, oh, my God, you know, she was my teen idol. That's the way it is. That's the way the world works, you know. But it's nothing I can do about that, really, and I'm not fussed.
Can you ever envision a day when you will not be doing this, when you'll call it quits?
I can't really envisage it, you know, because I've always thought, well, you know, okay, there'll be a time when I can't sort of be singing high rock and roll stuff like I do now. But I'll just slow them down a bit, bring the key down a bit, write something a bit slower, a bit more. I mean, that's the nice thing about writing, is that if you can't perform anymore, you still can write. I mean, there's like Irving Berlin in this city, what's he, he's like 103 or something? And he's still like, they asked him if they could use one of his songs. He said, only a portion of it. You know, he's still on the ball, this guy. So I look forward to a long career, and who knows?
Certainly had a long, great one already. The tour opens September 26th in Oslo, Norway. McCartney won't arrive in the U.S. until November 27th with shows in Los Angeles, Chicago, and New York City. Then he'll be back again in early 1990. Tomorrow, more with Paul and his backup musician and wife, Linda.
So who's your favorite Beatle?
Since we have one more part, can I take the fifth on that one? But McCartney did tell me, this is interesting, he said that his wife's favorite Beatle was John.
find out about that tomorrow. I don't know, but I think I would have been stunned to be standing that close to Paul McCartney. Were you speechless at all?
Not quite, but close.
You've interviewed Lennon McCartney before, so that's old hat for you, I guess. 10 minutes before the hour. Next.